YouTubers, truth seekers, and Mandela affected. I'm Dark Wolf, and this is Dark Wolf's Den. This is Mandela Effect Theory Series video number 9. Are the Mandela effects or Mandelisms actually parts of a coded message? So this is a theory that I came up with on my own at the very beginning when I first found out about the Mandela effect and found that there were certain words and letters that were just completely missing or changed or what the case may be. Of course, my very first one was Berenstein, and that changed from an E to an A. So that's a prime example. And it made me wonder if there was some kind of message being sent across time to somebody who might be able to do something about it. Say a time traveler lost in a time loop or whatever the case may be. We'll speculate on ideas of who could be causing this later. But let's focus on the why it could be a message first, or why I think it could be a message. And I've actually had some backing on this in the community, so I hope y'all like it. If you disagree, that's fine. You're more than welcome to disagree. That's what this is about, is theorizing and coming up with a better idea if we can't come up with this, or if this is the one that fits. But I really feel good about this one. So let's see what we got to start with. First, we got specific letter changes. A lot of Mandela effects have noticed the S either dropping off or appearing. And this also deals with apostrophes, because some of the words have to have an apostrophe with the letter for it to make sense. So you also have apostrophes appearing and disappearing along with the words. And you have words changing, spelling changing insanely, like Fruit Loops from UI to double O. You have the he and they. So if I may make a conjecture about this particular one, I'm not a debunker by any means. Anybody who's watched my videos knows this. I try not to debunk. I try merely to lay logic to things. I remember the movie Field of Dreams. And I do remember that in the very first whispering scene, the voice says he. And at the end, towards the end of the movie, or the next time the voices speak, it says they. And at first it's referring to his father, and then the entire team coming, and then the entire group of people at the very end who would come see everything. So I remember both those being in the movie originally. I personally don't count it as a Mandela effect. However, it's accepted by the community, so I'll keep it in this list just for the simple fact to show that even if this one isn't, there's a pile of evidence to prove that there's many more that are. We've got loop to know, like Luke, I am your father, to know I am your father, which sounds so horribly wrong to me. We have is and was. We have A and the, like a vampire, the vampire, for instance. We have word clusters like Sally Fields, you like me, you really like me. Change to right now, you like me. So we've got yeah, right, or you really, I'm sorry, you really to right now. So you've got full word changes, word clusters, letters, dashes, oh, dashes like the Kit Kat or the Coca-Cola, which could even imply either a, like, coordinate system, like hyphens, which we'll get to later, or the Morse code idea, dashes appearing or disappearing, creating a Morse code effect and a message being sent that way. Though I'm not as big on this, but perhaps the message wasn't getting through, so another means was attempted. It's just a theory. What else do we have here? We have, the Volvo symbol. It's been changed to a male symbol. We'll get into why that might be important shortly. And if that wasn't enough, that's just pop culture movie references. Oh, that's not a whole lot of information to go on, correct? Well, that's correct. But there's a whole nother group of words that have been some annihilated, some changed, but a whole lot changed. And that's the Bible. I know you've heard me speak of this in other videos. The Bible changes are numerous. I was surprised when doing the research for this exactly how numerous these were. Like, you've got the word couch replacing the word mat, the word matrix replacing womb, bottles replacing wineskins, aliens replacing foreign, in replacing on. Well, that's just a letter change. Well, that's a whole word. It might just be a letter that's changed, but that letter changed the entire word. Slay from shoe or show, like it speaks of, Jesus speaks of show my enemies to me. Now it says slay my enemies before me. So there's a change there. We have banks, which were the money exchangers. I remember the money exchangers being referenced in the KJV. It now says banks. How weird is that? Published to, or from preach the gospel, or the gospel will be preached in all lands to published in all lands. Published. How could it be published? How could they know about publishing in 1611? That wasn't invented for another couple hundred of years. So why would that be in the KJV 1611 original King James Bible? That does not make sense. We've also got from scroll to book. They used scrolls back then. Why would they speak of a book? Yes, books were known, don't get me wrong. But most of the references, if not all the references in the Bible, are scrolls. Why is it changed to books? From one to thing. I don't know the exact reference verse on that one, but one has been changed to thing. So as I look at this, now we went through the correlation differences. Let's take off one set of words. Let's take off the set of words that it originally was. And let's just look at the new words. We've got couch, matrix, bottles, wolf, alien, in, slay, banks, published, books, thing. Then coupled with the no, was, stuff, the, it's almost like they're trying to send a message and we're finding the pieces out of order. If it is a message of some type, it's like it's a great big puzzle or codes, and we can only find parts of the code or parts of the data to put together, which makes the whole decoding everything a whole lot harder. Maybe we're not finding in the right order. Maybe we're only finding certain pieces and not all of it. The speculations are endless, but if there's a cryptographer there out there who can take this information and run with it, that's why I do these videos, is to put the information in the community that maybe somebody else can hear it, get the idea, maybe take something they know or something they're good at and expand upon it. Maybe we can come up with a full answer in the end. That's what this is, the purpose of these are. Another weird correlation I found is the Star Wars quote, from Luke, I am your father, to No, I'm your father. Luke was taken out. It is interesting that there's changes in the Bible. And the word Luke is a verse or a book in the Bible. It is not the book that speaks of the lion and the lamb or anything. But it is a book in the Bible where Jesus speaks. Yes, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John all have Jesus speaking. However, it's still semi-significant, perhaps. I'm not saying it is, I'm not saying it ain't. But it could be. And the more I look at this, the more I find there's really a likelihood there's a message in this information. I don't understand why, I don't understand how, but there could it be somehow, just for sake of conversation and argument, with specific letter changes, specific word changes, could somebody be trying to send a message to someone else through time? Whether it be, well, we'll get into the why and who shortly. I also found another weird correlation that I just could not explain. Words with very specific letter changes like Berenstein to Berenstain, E to an A, liquefy to liquefy. I personally remember the I being in the word, now spelled L-I-Q-U-E-F-Y. That's strange to me. No, you just didn't know how to spell. You're just a bad speller. That's bad grammar. Well, that's funny because my spelling and grammar were top-notch and on par at the very top all through school and most of my life. I pride myself on knowledge and being able to spell and read the longer and more hard to understand words sometimes. But, you know, I don't know how to spell just some words. The simple ones just baffle me, right? It's just confabulation. I can't buy that. There's too many of them. Not all the changes I agree with. I can't say they all affect me. But isn't it kind of the thing about the Mandela Effect that it doesn't affect everybody? Somebody respectfully disagreed with my last video, the Back to the Future video, and that's fine. That's absolutely fine. I'm glad they did, because it goes to show that though they affect certain people, there are people that on the same comment thread that said it did affect them. Not to say that either person was wrong, because I believe that it affected both groups. To me and a group of people out there remember one way, whereas not everybody, even Mandela affected, remember that way. It's one of the odd anomalies about this effect, one that I'm yet to find a way to explain. and one that I've got in the data that I'm going to work on. So I'm starting to digress from my point. My point is, I really believe there's a message here. And like I said, liquefy I is changed to E. Bernstein E is changed to A. Well, okay, that don't really make any matches, right? You're right. So definitely. I remember definitely. I can distinctly remember definitely. And that it doesn't make sense, finite, definitely. Yes, it does make sense. It does. But I remember definitely. Now it's definitely. I to an A. Huh. Well, that's interesting. E to an A, an I to an A. The A here's popping up. Separate. I remember S-E-P-E-R-A-T-E. It's now S-E-P-A-R-A-T-E. Oh, yeah, I know I'm such a bad speller. There's such words I can't get right. Yet I can spell confabulation without a problem. How interesting is that? I don't confabulate any letters in the word confabulation, but just certain words I confabulate letters in. Just, I randomly choose those words, right? I know that's a bit sarcastic. I don't think that's what's going on, confabulation or anything of that nature. I think there is something to this. But I brought those points up to say that the liquefy, the E, became a letter in there. Definitely, A became a letter. Separate, A became a letter. Bernstein, A became a letter. It's weird that this A keeps popping up, isn't it? Really strange. Well, if it is a coded message, wouldn't there need to be a key? Perhaps this is only part of the key. Because like I said, I don't think we have all the data yet. I really, really don't. And I don't think we're finding all the data sources in order. I think we're only finding bits and pieces at a time. And I think that what we are putting together is highly speculative, yes, but it's one of the most logical theories that I've been able to come up with so far. And it's one that I've been working on for quite a while. And the more I look into it, the more I work on it, the more correlations I'm able to find within the words, the letters. And then you can get into gematria, or the number system pertaining to the letters that have changed or the words that have changed. I don't have enough time on my hands to get the breakdowns of all those. I have thought about it, yes, not to an extent that I have all the data on it. If somebody out there would like to do this study, please, by all means, I ask you to take it up. Let us know what you find out. If you don't make a YouTube video about it, put something in the comments. But please, let us know what you find out if you take this on. We need to share information around the community and see if we can't figure out what's going on with this effect. And see if we can't find a solution as to why. So that would bring me to my last topic of this video. And I know it's taken a little while. I hope you all enjoyed the long videos. I know I've been doing a lot of short ones lately, but now I'm able to expand it with the length of the videos and maybe even more data in them. And I'm going to try to access more data and give more specific examples as I go on. Of course, all of these are Mandela Effect specific examples. So, you know, verification outside of the Mandela Effect is a little hard. This is for people that really, truly believe in it and want to find a correlation within the actual data that we have so far. The data we have, like I said, with the letters and everything, I believe it correlates to a message. I believe there's a key in here hidden somewhere. And perhaps even like the Kit Kat. Somebody brought up earlier to me that the Kit Kat commercial used to be 3 for me, 2 for you. Well, that makes 5. My math is not the best. I'm not algebraically gifted as far as like higher levels of algebra. But I'm pretty sure I remember 3 plus 2 equaling 5. I haven't looked to find the old commercials. If somebody wants to do that, please, by all means. But 3 plus 2 is 5. The Kit Kat packs are 4. Now, how in the world does that make sense that the commercials used to be 3 and 2 is 5? That's kind of odd. So, 5 to 4, along the key code idea, perhaps that's part of a key code. Move back 1. The fifth letter is E. Bernstein and a couple others had E's in them that were changed. If we correlate those with other words, which, again, I don't have the time to do. But if you want to list out these and try to correlate likenesses and differences or see if there's a code within them, please, I beg of you, take this on. If you're a cryptographer, here's you a new puzzle. If you're a gematrist, here's you something new to play with. Maybe you can come up with something. Maybe it's going to come out as garbled data. I don't know. But at least we can try. And that's all I ask is if you listen to these and if it clicks something in you, please try. If you're just listening to these because of curiosity, excellent. I'm glad you're here. I'm glad you've opened your mind to the ideas that could or could not be. And I try to present my ideas with an unbiased point of view, why it could be or it could not be. I know I'm excited about this. I'm postponing. So let's move on to the very last topic we have. Who or why could it be sending the message? So I've come up with a couple ideas of who or why it could be. It could be a time traveler. Well, if you go back to the past, and there's a lot of problem with the time travel theory, we wouldn't know a change from the past now, and I'll get into that in a whole other video. Besides that, it could be a time traveler from the past, or it could be somebody sending a message back from the future. Here's something that hasn't been looked at a lot at all. What if somebody in the future is trying to get our attention back here for whatever reason? If there is a reason, perhaps there's a message coded in the changes that are being made. Interesting. And then there's the last one that I have. Perhaps a scientist has decided that they figured out how to make changes in reality, or want to send a message to somebody on the outside and try to tell us something without the mainstream or anybody else finding out. For only the clever ones to find out. Kind of like the cicada 3301, I believe it is, or whatever the number under it is. How they have the intricate number puzzles and the picture puzzles and whatnot. What if somebody's sending, a scientist, for instance, sending us a message for only the ones clever enough to figure it out to figure out? Why do I think it could be purposeful, say a scientist doing this, for instance? Well, look at some of the changes. Like Mickey Mouse. He didn't have suspenders. All of a sudden, after everybody went looking and talking about it, there was something about his tail suddenly appearing. Now, that's kind of strange. Why would there be another Mickey Mouse one that close together, in effect? Unless somebody had heard it and was going back and trying to change things, or trying to fix up their foul up. And I wonder about some of the letters, too. If it isn't code, perhaps somebody's trying to fix up foul ups and screwing up horribly. They're not fixing anything at all, but just making things worse. This is, of course, speculation and theory. But it's one of... like I said, one of, if you want to count two or three on the time traveler idea, past and future, one of a couple ideas of who or why could be causing it. So we have motive, we have opportunity, if you consider it, and we have something going on clearly in effect. So if it is a message being sent back, if there is anybody who wants to help break this or take this information to another level, please, by all means, feel free to. I would love to hear from you. If you guys think this is a good theory, let me know. Make sure you hit that like button. Make sure you subscribe. I try to put out videos pretty normally. I can't promise every day because I do have a lot of research to do on these. But I will try to put out videos with a good amount of evidence and a good amount of backup on either side for the pros or cons. So bear with me. I will update the channel pretty regularly. Please share it with your friends. If anybody's thinking about the why on this, or the cause, or the theories as to why, I absolutely think that's a wonderful idea. Make YouTube videos about it. Tell the world. Tell the community. Let us all know. Share everything you can come up with. Because even the wildest idea could be the correct idea. You never know. No thought is wrong. I don't believe so. There are just different sides of looking at. Sometimes the exact same coin, you could have 8 or 9 different sides to look at it. So again, please like, subscribe. I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you understood what my rambling was. I hope you've enjoyed my rambling and been able to put up with it thus far. If you're still sticking around, thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you to everybody that has subscribed to the channel so far. It really means a lot to me that have subscribed to the channel so far. I'm getting a little tongue-tied here. Anyway, it really means a lot to me. I really, really appreciate it. It's what keeps us going. Make sure you like us again if you like this theory, if you think anything's to it. If you can come up with more evidence to back it or against it, by all means, post it in the comments. I'm not against changing my ideas. Now, I won't go in all the way and say this is confabulation. Oh, this is just wrong. You're right. Convince me I'm wrong. No, if that is your intention, sorry. I'll never believe that. You can waste your time commenting. I doubt you're going to be very well received in the community. That said, thank you everybody for listening. I hope y'all have enjoyed this. I hope y'all have a very wonderful day, night, morning, evening, wherever you may be. And as always, please remember, stay awake. Thank you very much, ladies.